The wiggle method is one of the most popular and rewarding beginner expressions. If you've ever used the wiggler panel in After Effects, this expression does the same job, but with fewer keyframes. Wiggle animates between random values based on arguments you give it. The wiggle expression has three parts: the method name, wiggle, and the two arguments, frequency and amplitude. So you input the frequency of wiggles per second and amplitude based on how far the value should fluctuate. The method name is all lowercase, and the two arguments are wrapped in parentheses and separated by a comma and an optional space. It operates directly on the existing property value, including any keyframes. Okay, so let's see what you can do with the wiggle expression. The rocket rotates around the planet using keyframes. If you twirl down the rocket layer's contents, open the flame group, find the flame transform properties, highlight the scale property, you can solo it by double tapping S. And now you can add a wiggle expression to the rocket's flame to make it look like it has some thrust while the rocket moves. So the first thing you want to do is add an expression to the scale property by alt-clicking the stopwatch. And we're going to start with a basic wiggle expression. So wiggle, open parentheses, 10, comma, 10, close parentheses. Once you're done typing this, if you click outside of the expression field to save your changes, and if you scrub the playhead, you'll notice the rocket's flame has some randomness, which adds a lot of life to the animation. Now you can also add some random twinkling to the stars around the planet. So if you collapse up the rocket by hitting U on your keyboard and highlight a star layer, you can hit T on your keyboard to open up opacity, and you can add a new expression to this property by alt-clicking the stopwatch. Now for this expression, I'm going to type wiggle, open parentheses, 2 for the frequency, and 20 for the amplitude. Now if you click away from the expression field, it's going to save your changes. And if you come over and right-click the opacity property and hit copy expression only, it's going to copy the expression to the clipboard, and then you can select the rest of the stars and Control V or Command V on a Mac to paste the expression. And if you hit T, you'll notice that all of these expressions are now applied. And now if you RAM preview, you'll notice that all the stars randomly twinkle in the sky. And so now you can just add a quick finishing touch to the Z rotation. Just gonna give it one rotation across 5 seconds. And now you have your complete scene. So now I'm going to show you a quick bonus example, and we're going to do a Steadicam shake on the camera layer. So this technique is pretty simple to do. First, you're going to want to hit P on your keyboard to open the camera's position property, and then just add an expression by alt-clicking the stopwatch. This expression is going to use 4 arguments. The last 2 are optional. So first, you want to open this up by typing in wiggle, open parentheses. The first argument, frequency, is going to be 1, comma. The second argument, amplitude, is going to be 10, comma. The third argument is a new optional one for octaves, and we're going to set that to 2, comma. And the fourth optional argument is amplitude multiplier, which is basically an intensity value. And you're going to set that to 0.25. And after this fourth argument, close it with a close parentheses and click off the expression field to save your changes. So if you have a keen eye, you might have noticed that the camera's position has changed, and it's because these values have slightly shifted from their original position. And if you RAM preview your scene, you'll notice that the camera has a nice shake to it, and this is a great technique for adding a Steadicam effect to your After Effects camera or footage layer. You can find the wiggle expression syntax in the expression language menu under the property category. We've arrived at the end of lesson 201. An overview of the popular wiggle expression. If you enjoy this expressions course, consider purchasing the paid content. It includes in-depth documentation, extra tutorial content, high-definition videos, and all the project files used in the training. Your purchase will help to create more free courses like this in the future.